We at the VA realize that your path has likely been very overwhelming since finding out that you have cancer. This video will go over how your cancer medicine or chemotherapy will work to kill the cancer, what side effects the medicine may cause, and what you can do to help treat these side effects. Cancer cells grow and multiply faster than most healthy, non-cancer cells in your body. Chemotherapy will work to kill the cancer by targeting fast-growing cells. Unfortunately, there are some areas in the body that have normal cells that also grow fast but are not cancer. These are areas that will be affected by the cancer drugs and where we can expect some side effects to happen. The first part of the body with normal, fast-growing cells is the digestive system. Nausea, or the queasy feeling in your stomach like you are going to throw up, is a common side effect of chemotherapy. To help prevent nausea from happening, you will get anti-nausea medications at the infusion clinic before you get your chemotherapy. You will also get some anti-nausea medications to have at home in case you need them. When you are at home, you should take one of the anti-nausea medications right away if you start to feel any nausea. When you take the anti-nausea medication, we hope your nausea will go away completely, but it should at least be manageable for you. Call your cancer team if you feel like the anti-nausea medication is not working. You will know if the medication is not working because you will feel like you can't eat or drink without getting sick, or you get so nauseous that you throw up. Your cancer team can change the medications to help you feel better if this happens. Another possible side effect in the digestive system that can occur is diarrhea. What we expect to happen is some loose stools that you are able to manage. We never want it to get so bad that you feel like food and water go right through you, or you feel extra thirsty or weak from having so much diarrhea. If you have four or more loose stools in 24 hours, or a lot of stomach pain and cramping, call your cancer team right away and they can make changes to help you feel better. It is important to stay hydrated throughout the day while you are being treated for cancer. Staying hydrated helps protect your kidneys. Drinking water is the best. However, you can get fluid in other ways, like flavored water, sparkling water, sports drinks with electrolytes, tea, and juices. Even some foods, such as soup, can be hydrating and help you get enough fluid each day. Another area in the body that has fast-growing cells is the mouth. Some people can get mouth sores from cancer medications. If these mouth sores are ever painful or they prevent you from eating or drinking, call your cancer team right away. One thing you can do to help with mouth sores is a salt rinse. To make a salt rinse, take 4 measuring cups of water and add 1 teaspoon of salt and 1 teaspoon of baking soda to the water and stir it. You can keep the salt rinse in a refillable container in the refrigerator and use it 3 to 4 times per day. Take a sip of the salt rinse and swish it in your mouth for 15 to 30 seconds and spit it out in the sink. Not only will the salt rinse help heal mouth sores quicker, but it also helps prevent mouth sores from developing. The next area in the body that has fast-growing cells is your bone marrow, or the part of the body that makes the cells that are in your blood. Your blood has white blood cells, red blood cells, and platelets. Your cancer team will be watching your blood cell counts closely. It is normal for the number of cells to go down a little after chemotherapy, but they are expected to come back up to normal levels before your next dose of chemotherapy. The white blood cells fight off infection. After chemotherapy, the number of white blood cells will go down. While these are low, you will be more likely to get sick or get an infection. However, there are some things you can do to help prevent infections. The first thing you can do to help prevent infections is to wash your hands often, especially before touching anywhere that bacteria or viruses can get into the body, such as your eyes, nose, and mouth. If you have any friends or family who want to visit, but they are just getting over a cold, or they were recently with someone who is sick, you should delay that visit until everyone is healthy. Any remaining sickness they have can easily be given to you. If you ever have a fever, which we consider to be a temperature of 100.4 degrees Fahrenheit or higher, you need to call your cancer team right away. Often, when your blood counts are low, that is your body's only way to tell you that something is wrong. The red blood cells are cells that carry oxygen around the body. When these cells are low, people tend to feel more tired. You will likely get tired more quickly compared to before chemotherapy. The important thing about this is to listen to your body. You will have days where you feel more tired, and on these days, be sure to listen to your body and rest. On the other hand, you will also have days where you feel like you have more energy. Feel free to go for a walk or be more active on these days. Being active can also prevent fatigue. Platelet cells form blood clots and stop us from bleeding. When these are low, you might notice that you bruise more easily, or cuts and scrapes will bleed a little bit longer than normal. If you ever notice that a bruise is growing and looks worse, or it is raised up and hard in the center, let your cancer team know so we can be sure you aren't bleeding under the skin. If you ever have bleeding that does not stop within 5 minutes, like a cut or a nosebleed, let your cancer team know right away. There should also never be blood anywhere that there normally isn't blood. So if you ever see blood in your urine, which can look more brown like tea, or in your stool, which might look dark or sticky, let your cancer team know right away. If you are worried at all about any bleeding when the cancer clinic is closed, you should call the 24-hour nurse triage line and they can help you with next steps. In summary, the main side effects of chemotherapy are nausea, diarrhea, mouth sores, and a low number of blood cells that can increase risk of getting sick, make you feel more tired, and increase your risk of bleeding. You should always call your cancer team if you get so much nausea that you are afraid to eat or drink because you think that you'll get sick, or if you have so much nausea that you throw up. You should always call your cancer team if you have 4 or more loose stools or diarrhea per day, or if you have really bad stomach pain and cramping. You should always call your cancer team if you have painful mouth sores that prevent you from eating or drinking. You should always call your cancer team if you have a fever, which is a temperature of 100.4 degrees Fahrenheit or higher. You should always call your cancer team if you have any concerns for bleeding, whether it be a bruise that is getting worse or not healing, a cut that won't stop bleeding, or if there is blood somewhere that it shouldn't be. Your cancer team is here for you throughout this journey. The phone numbers listed here are for veterans receiving care at the VA hospital in Madison, Wisconsin. Please do not hesitate to call your cancer team if you have any questions or concerns. If you are getting your care at another VA, please ask your cancer team for the best phone numbers to contact them at your next visit. We thank you very much for your service, and again, please do not hesitate to reach out with any questions or concerns. Thank you.